How's everybody doing today? This is Antonio Moore coming to you from Tone Talks. I wanted to have a brief discussion about the Harriet Tubman film. And also wanted to talk about Comcast and the Civil Rights Act of 1866 and how they all tie together. This is Tone Talks along with theGrio. Let's have that talk. So, you know, Civil Rights Act of 1866 is being heard by the Supreme Court November 13th, less than a month away. Essentially, you have Comcast attacking the Civil Rights Act of 1866 and bringing about a whole question of whether we'll be able to use this Civil Rights Act going forward. They're trying to make it so that you have to reach this but-for standard. You have Byron Allen, a media mogul, who has a lawsuit that he won in the Ninth Circuit that basically brings the standard to motivating factor. Ninth Circuit has already agreed. Essentially, Comcast is attacking the Civil Rights Act of 1866, while at the same time, one of its subsidiaries through NBC Universal Focus Features is putting out the film Harriet Tubman. Harriet Tubman's first film is being done by Cynthia Erivo. I personally made my own questions, both of her disparaging comments about African Americans, in addition to the fact that we don't know if she's Dialia or Ohu. Dialia being the freeborn Igbos that traded slaves, I believe that's a big question. But right now we're having the issue about the economics and business behind it all. And what we're looking at is Harriet Tubman, who was in her 60s or 70s when the Civil Rights Act of 66 is passed, who's there pushing for rights for all black folks, friends of Frederick Douglass, is basically being sold by the same company or commercialized by the same company that is attacking the Civil Rights Act of 1866. Saying a little bit about the Civil Rights Act of 1866, it was the first Civil Rights Act. It was done a year after freedom from slavery in 65. Essentially, you have Harriet Tubman, the Underground Railroad, freeing people from bondage. But the next step of freedom was actually to make people American. You can't see anything but the Civil Rights Act of 1866 coming directly out of the body of work of Harriet Tubman. To now have Comcast trying to attack those rights in real life while selling Harriet's story is a contradiction like we've never seen before. Today, ADOS has called for a boycott of the Harriet film based on the fact of that. We feel it's a tragedy that we as African Americans can't support a film about one of our great icons. But at the same time, we have to be real about the rights that are present and in front of us that are being trampled upon and trying to be taken back, and the consequence of that. Do we understand the consequence of no longer being able to use a Civil Rights Act that sets out the first framework for anyone that's non-white to do contracting? I come to you today because in so many ways, we see actions happening across the country. Just recently in New Jersey, an ADOS member joined the local NAACP chapter and explained the Comcast lawsuit to the president. They canceled their screenings. And many times, what happens with these films, African-American films, is that the model for promotion is right around a week before to screen them with churches and civil rights orgs like the NAACP, like ADOS chapters, like Urban League. And what happens is that creates the promotional energy for the film. Well, if you have a lawsuit in the Supreme Court attacking the Civil Rights Act less than a month away, you don't deserve that support. And we saw that with the NAACP there in New Jersey, and I want to shout them out, because what you saw is their ability to advocate for the civil rights that they're supposed to represent. You see them standing up and saying, we're not going to screen a film done by a company that is attacking the civil rights of black folks and other folks in the Supreme Court less than a month away. Just reading a small bit of an article written on this from the Philadelphia Inquirer, a South New Jersey NAACP chapter has canceled a screening of a film by Harriet Tubman, saying it opposes Comcast's appeal in a case over the nation's oldest civil rights law that, if successful, will make it harder to file racial discrimination lawsuits. And you see a tweet actually done by an ADOS member triggered from the ADOS conference, where they essentially were told about a project takeover where we were trying to transform these organizations and give them new life with black folks that are about a black agenda, reparations, and demanding just to be respected. And what you see is that Jasmine, a young woman in New Jersey, attended my first NAACP meeting, and I'm excited to work with them. I told them about the Comcast case and the relationship to Focus Features, and they canceled their private screenings of Harriet. ADOS at SBCNJ NAACP is ready to do it. And I just have to commend both that organization for being open to this young woman, because that only invites more people to come. and also the young woman for going to the meeting and being triggered by Ados. This is the moment where we start to demand more. We have a major issue right in front of us, less than a month away, with the Civil Rights Act of 1866 and a 5-4 conservative leaning court. What we have to do is make our voices known. Ados has called for a boycott of this film, Harriet, based on the fact that it's owned by a subsidiary of Comcast through NBC Universal Focus Features. And I believe that in many ways, what we have to do is make sure that they hear our voice. If you're gonna put out a film based on Harriet Tubman, who through the Underground Railroad freed so many slaves and literally not recognize the impact that attacking the Civil Rights Act of 1866 has at the same time, it needs to be known that we're not gonna support your film. I believe that this video needs to be shared. I believe that this movement needs to be shared. Everyone has to understand what it means for African Americans across this nation not to be able to support the Harriet Tubman film as a result of what Comcast has done in the Supreme Court. Some people might say, well, you can do both. You can't. And in this moment, what happens is you need to let it be known that Comcast cannot attack the Civil Rights Act of 1866 while at the same time creating immense amounts of dollars on the imagery of Harriet Tubman. They do not go together. Essentially, all of the actors in the film should be speaking out. All of the actors across the nation and the producers across the nation that are African American and beyond should be speaking out. This is unacceptable. And essentially, I just wanted to come to you to connect the dots and show you the connection between Harriet the film and the Civil Rights Act of 1866, which will be in the Supreme Court in less than a month. Thank you. And shout out again to the NAACP and that member, Jasmine.